I'm going to show you how to make a 3D video Instagram post using PowerDirector. Let's pop right on out this post. Let's start off by changing our aspect ratio so it matches the Instagram requirements. We're going to go up here to Edit. We're going to go to Aspect Ratio. And we're going to select a 4x5. Next, we want to add our Instagram image to the timeline. We're going to go up to this image, hold on our left mouse button, and we're going to drag this down to track one. Now, we got some black on the sides of this, and it's not scaled all the way up, so we're going to use the PIP designer to fix that. So we're going to left double click on this with our mouse. We're going to change our scale. You can use your slider here, or you can use the nodes by hovering over them and using nodes to change it. I'm just going to type in what I want. And then I'm going to make sure that my Y and my X axis are where I want them. So I'm good to go here. I'm going to go ahead and click on OK. Now we're going to add the butterfly video. So we're going to hold on our left mouse button over this and we're going to drag it down to track two. We're going to change the duration of the image so it's the same length as the video clip. So I'm going to left click on it. And I'm going to move my cursor to the end of the clip until I see two arrows pointed in opposite direction. I'm going to hold down my left mouse button. And I'm going to drag this out. Now we'll go ahead and add the chroma key to remove the green background from the butterfly image. So I'm going to move my playhead to a position where I can see the butterfly on the screen. Then I'm going to double left click on this to open up the PIP designer. And I'm going to scroll down to the chroma key section. I'll enable the chroma key. I'm going to click on the color picker and I'll click on green. And then you can change the color range to whatever you need to make it look more realistic, get any green edges off of it, stuff like that. And now we want to make the butterfly come out of the side of the screen and go down to being outside of the post using keyframes. So we're going to move our playhead to a position where the butterfly first comes onto the screen. And I'm going to place my cursor over this box until I see crosshairs. I'm going to hold on my left mouse button and I'm going to drag this up. Now I'm going to move my playhead all the way back to the beginning. And I'm going to place a position keyframe here and a scale keyframe here. Now I'm going to move my playhead to a position where I want the butterfly to start moving down. And that's good here. I'm going to add a position keyframe. And I'm going to add a scale keyframe. And this will lock in the position and scale from 0 to 5 seconds. And then I want to move forward one more second. So I'm going to go to 6 seconds on here. And now I want to move the butterfly down into the white section and scale it up to make it look like it's coming closer to the individual watching the video. So I'm going to scroll up here. And for the width, I'll scale this up. And once again, you can use the nodes if you want to. It's up to you. You can use the sliders. All those options are out there for you. I'm just typing in what I want. And then to move it a little bit over, I'm going to go to there. And I'm going to move it down a little bit. So I'm going to use my Y axis for that. Then I'm going to move my playhead forward to a position where I want the butterfly to start flying off the screen. And I'm going to go ahead and add a position keyframe. And I'm gonna add a scale keyframe. So that'll lock in the butterfly at this position between these two keyframes. And then I'm gonna move my playhead to a position where I want the butterfly to be flying off the screen. I'm gonna bring the scale back down to the original scale, which was a 1. And I'm going to change my X and my Y position to move the individual butterfly up the screen. Now I'm gonna go ahead and click on OK. And let's play this back, see what it looks like. Oh, we just got it popping. If you want to use Chroma Key to make a cool X-ray effect, check out this tutorial. Don't forget to smash my face to subscribe, hit me up with your comments, and drop me a like down below.